But yeah, so manufacturing has come a long ways. I'd like to say we moved it from art towards science. It's a reason for civilization and the oldest profession in the world. Now, we know it's manufacturing because it's a customer that wants to buy it, right? And somebody here said that we were going to add value to our parts.
Don't let me go over the time. I tend to go over the time. I like to hear myself talk.
So, what is value? Yeah. I can't see it from here.
Matthew. How much someone's willing to pay for your product?
How much someone is willing to pay for your product? Okay. Who's the someone?
The customer.
The customer. Okay. Anybody think value means something else?
No.
All right, so value is how much the customer is willing to pay for your part, product, widget, whatever you want to call it, your stuff.
How do you know what the value is? Yeah, Rashi.
Value of raw material and how much profit you want.
Keep those words in mind. How do you know what the value of your part is? Not fail, right? You know what the value is because they did buy it. Until they actually buy it, you only think you know what the value is. Once they did buy it, you know what the value is. And value can change, right?
Right.
Now, anybody got anything else?
How many customers are willing to buy it?
Like, yeah, I guess then it's just, then was that like the first derivative? It's like value over time, something like that. So the rate at which you can sell it. Yeah. Keep that in mind. Yeah.
If you
want
to make a profit, how much it costs to pay.
All right, so we're jumping ahead, right? But is this value? Okay. What's that worth? If it was real. You know, before I got married, I actually used to do this lecture with a real $100 bill. But my wife doesn't let me carry those anymore. So, what's the value of a $100 bill?
Somebody should say $100.
$100.
All right. Matt, why is a $100 bill worth $100?
Because the U.S. government says it is.
Yeah, I think it's even broader than that. I mean, everybody's been watching Bitcoin, right? The $100 bill is worth $100 because we agree that it's worth $100 and for no other reason. Anybody know what the cost of a $100 bill is? So depending on what year it was made, it's either 12 or 7 cents to make a $100 bill. And that's a business to be in, huh? It's like printing money. Yeah, okay. So what's the difference between cost and value? Two people have said it already when I was trying to get value, right? It's the difference between cost and value. It's profit, right? So value minus cost equals profit. That is the first equation in the 1800. People have complained in past class. You know, you fill out the little thing at the end of the term. Everybody ever fill out one of those little things at the end of the term, like course evaluation stuff? So comments have come back. They said, he talks too much about business in the engineering class. And so, everybody stand up. Where was the radio? Everybody standing? Sit back down if you have a trust fund. Okay, the rest of us are going to need a job someday, right? So I do talk about business when we talk about manufacturing and we talk about engineering, because I would rather work at a company that's not going to fail. And I think you should rather work at a company that's not going to fail also. So we need to sit back up. But I think we should think about, and that's my answer to people who complain I talk too much about this. And I'm certain that in one of the classes I've done this is with people who are in that trust fund, but they weren't willing to sit down. So I'm not picking on you if you have a lot of money. Just value equals cost minus profit. What's the first derivative of profit over time? First derivative of profit with respect to time? It's easy, because I'm an engineer, I'm going to estimate the calculus, I'm not going to do the calculus. Profit over time. Profit over time equals profit rate. Our job as manufacturing engineers is to try to help our companies have a positive profit rate. If the profit rate for my company is positive, that means the company is growing. And companies that are not growing are dying. So, our job as manufacturers is to help make a positive profit rate. We're going to talk about how to control and add value to the parts that we make through manufacturing. We're going to talk about the costs of manufacturing. And so if we want to maximize profit rate, what do we need to do? There's only